So the conventional wisdom among neuroscientists is that progress in brain research can achieve a deep understanding of the phenomenal experience of consciousness, the inner feeling of what it's like. You reject that. You say that the neural correlates of consciousness may do a whole lot of other good things to learn, but it will not explain the feeling of consciousness.
The reason for this, and it sounds perverse, is that the whole idea of the neural correlates of consciousness depends on the idea that there are conscious things going on in the brain and there are unconscious things going on in the brain. And this just shifts the mystery around. Now, what I'm not rejecting is the idea of the neural correlates of experiences or the neural correlates of actions. So the neuroscience is doing brilliantly at looking inside a brain. For example, if somebody's looking at a cat or they're looking at a house, and you look in the brain and you can see which bits doing what when they're looking at the cat or they're looking at the house. Or you can get them to do actions and you can find out what's going on in the brain if they choose to wiggle that finger or that finger. All this is the neural correlates of actions, perceptions, thoughts, memories, and we're getting, the neuroscientists who do this are getting brilliant at it.
Sure.
But the idea of the neural correlates of consciousness is the idea that we will find those bits that give rise to consciousness. The consciousness neurons, as Francis Crick used to call them, or Ramachandran says, the ones that produce qualia. This is magic. I mean, the classic neural correlates of consciousness paradigm is something like you have binocular rivalry and some other type, or an ambiguous figure. And some of the time the person is seeing this and some of the time they're seeing that. That's in consciousness and that's not in consciousness. And you get them to report and you look at the neural correlates of consciousness. You look at the neural correlates. Well, what do you find? Not surprisingly, the one they report, there's more activity going on and there's less in the one they're not reporting and so on. But that's not consciousness itself. That's finding out what's going on in the reportability. So I think in the end...
Correlation is the right word. It's not
correlation.
Causation.
Yes, precisely. Yeah. And it's not that something called consciousness itself is exuded and we can find which bits of the brain or which processes are exuding it. It's this brain doing its stuff and somehow we attribute... this is what I would say. That's the reason that I reject it. But then I would go on to say we have to understand those correlations in another way without evoking this kind of magical idea that subjectivity is produced by, arises from, emerges from, because then we've got this dualist problem. You know, the search for the neural correlates of consciousness is essentially based in dualism. And that's nearly everyone says it doesn't, dualism doesn't work.
They claim that that's exactly the opposite of what they're trying to do.
Yeah.
Because we reject dualism, we reject immortal souls or spirits, and so we're going to find the brain causes of consciousness. So they think they're totally materialistic, but you're saying they're dualist because they're getting a magical a bubble pop.
Yeah, exactly.
Out of a neuron, you pop a consciousness experience.
And what I think we will find is the neural correlates of what gives rise to the delusions. So, for example, we'll find the neural correlates, we already know some of them, of the processes in the brain that construct the body schema, a self-image, a representation of what we're paying attention to, a sort of sketchy model of what I'm attending to and not attending to. These are important things. We've been hearing about them at this conference. I think we will then understand the neural correlates of what gives rise to our false ideas about consciousness in a way that we will never find the neural correlates of consciousness itself.
So what you're saying is the neural correlates of consciousness is a very worthy endeavor in order to clear out those aspects of consciousness which are confusing the question.
Yes. I hope it will prove that way, yes.
Right. And so you want to, you've said, retire them. Give them
that was because of the edge question. I mean, every year the edge community is asked a question. And this year is it, what scientific idea would you like to see retired?
Right.
So that was my choice. But actually, I don't mind whether it's retired or not. I think it will keep on struggling and it will give up because it will realize the problem.
So you are rejecting the neural correlates as a way of understanding deep inner experience of consciousness, certainly accepting it as explaining all of the many things that consciousness does and feels and sees.
Yeah, I think it doesn't do anything. It's not, consciousness to my mind is not what it seems to be. It's not a power. It's, in some sense, it's got to be just how it is. And I'm attributing that the stories this brain is telling are attributing to inventing this power of consciousness. What's doing the actions? What's causing all this to happen? What's causing the speech to come out of this mouth here? Are all the multifarious parallel processes going on? There's not something
right,
as well
right,
called
right.
consciousness, and that's why there's no point looking
but,
for
but
it.
But you still have that felt experience, that inner
yes,
experience.
Yes.
And so what do you do with that? Now you've retired, and you've rejected the neural correlates, and you've accepted them. So what do you do? Where are you? Where do you go? What direction do you turn?
Tell me that everything I say is rubbish, and I won't be that surprised. because you're right. You push me to what do I do? What do I actually do, if that's a real question? On the one hand, I read and listen to the stuff about the neuroscience and hope that I can get closer to understanding
right.
what the
maybe
brain's
you were
doing.
Wrong. Maybe you were wrong.
Yeah.
The neural correlates will pop out consciousness.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Or something else will change the picture. And on the other hand, I meditate a lot. I spend a lot of time walking around the streets or my garden at home or feeding the chickens, thinking, how can this be? What's going on? What is it really like? What am I conscious of now? I mean, I do a lot of asking myself
that's
the questions
good.
That
yes.
I put in my Zen yeah. book and in
yeah.
my textbook.
Yeah.
Am I conscious now? That has such a weird effect. If I ask myself, am I conscious now? I always am.
Yeah.
And this is really weird. I mean, one of those basic mysterious things about consciousness. If I ask myself, am I conscious now? I always am. What about a moment before? Well, hang on a minute. Something changed when I asked the question. I wasn't conscious a moment before. My interpretation of that is that in asking the question, a model of self and a model of what I'm, of a stream of consciousness comes up. They're ideas, representations of that. A moment before there wasn't, there was just an animal with multiple parallel things going on, reacting to all the things around, speaking and so on. But there was no fact of the matter about what I was conscious of, because there was neither a me or a stream of consciousness. Those things only appear when I ask the question, am I conscious now? Ooh, yeah, yeah, I'm in here behind the eyes looking out, that's what I'm conscious of. I think that states the clearest I can the way I think about it. And that's why I look at it from the objective neuroscience way and from my own experience, hoping that each can illuminate the other.